Hello guys, welcome back to the drama channel. This is Joel. I just noticed that Universitaly's website has got some minor updates, not too much, so don't worry about how you guys could proceed for making an account on it. So in this video, I'm just going to show you a quick and brief video and instruction how to open up the account and proceed for your application. Here, as you may see, I wrote Universitaly is just the name of it and the search bar, so you guys could write it simply here and could search it in the internet. And the first website is Universitaly's website in the direction of www.universitaly.it. When you click on it, this webpage is going to be here. And as you may see, you will see the several options here. So you could search for the course. You could do several things. You could find your answer to your questions and multiple things. You could find it easily here. So for our video, the purpose of our video, I'm going to just show you guys how to easily open an account on this website easily. So here, I'm just clicking on this account icon here, as you can see on the like right up corner of this video. I just click on it and it just brings me to the new page, which is the page you could enter the university portal. And if you go to if you're Italian or if you're living in Italy for several years, you could easily access by speed or card identity. But if you don't have it, you could also enter with your email or username with a password if you have an account before, okay, from before. So if you are new and if you are going to open an account now, you just could click easily on this link below, which is written registrarti. So it means that you're going to register an account here. So you're going to see here all the data, anagraphic data here. So as you may see, the name, surname, email, telephone number, and several things downside. So I'm just going step by step from here, from upside to down, to you guys could follow me from each bar, and you could correctly write your details and open an Universitaly account. First thing, you have to write your name in the first bar. In Italian, it is written nome, so you could write your name here. I'm going to write my name, so you guys should write your name. Okay. And afterward, it is written cognome, means that you have to write your surname. And your surname, whatever is yours also, you could have, I don't know, middle name, so you could include in the name section. So here I'm just writing the cognome as my frictional same surname, which is not mine, but I'm just going to show you as an example, okay? And you have to write your true surname. And here the email, you could write your email, which are you are always using it, and this is your main one. I recommend use your main email address so you would have access to your account easily. Okay, I just wrote my email here and it is all done. And my telephone number, I mean, you could have your own telephone number, so I'm going to write it down. Okay, so whatever is your phone number, so just write it down. I mean, it's not that much important in my opinion for the foreigners, but just some sort of obligatory information you got to put, okay? Okay, and in the Saturday Nashita, you gotta it depends where you born. I mean, it can be any country you're going to choose or anything. I mean, Italy, if you are Italian, or if you're Iranian, or I don't know, from Ireland, from Israel, from France, or from any other country, or Pakistan, you could just find it here. For example, for Pakistan, you could just, for India, for example, you can see it here. For Iran, you could find it here. For Israel, you could find it here. It's so easy to choose. I'm just going to put Italy as the as example purpose, okay? So provincia di nascita, okay, so I'm going to choose another country because most of the people who are going to register with Universitaly, I think they are going to be non-Italian guys. So I'm just going to choose, for example, Iran as a country. And here, comune esterno di nascita, going to, in my opinion, you gotta put EE. So it means that you are external. So you have to write here EE as the comune esterno di nascita. Data di nascita is asking you in which date you born. And I mean, this is the date of birth of yours, okay? So you got to choose it on, for example, we could say you're from, I don't know, 2003. And from August, from 14th August of 2003, okay? It's asking you your gender. You got to choose whatever is your gender. So you are if you're male or female. If you're male, you should use the masculine. If you're female, you just choose femmina. We can say masculine here as an example. And cittadinanza depends on which country you have the citizenship, okay? For example, because we choose Iran, we are choosing the Iran again here as citizenship since we are living there also. Okay. Here, as you may see, it is asking you a codice fiscale, which I assume most of you guys don't have it because you are not Italian and you're not living in Italy. But if you, for example, were living in Italy, you could have it from the embassy which gave you, or I don't know, from the also, and your document is written, okay, on the documents which embassy at the first time gave you. If you're Italian, of course, you could have it from the first day. If you're not Italian, you're not living in Italy, you could easily obtain it from the website I put here, as the codicefiscale.com. I would put it in the caption of the video, so you could easily just click on it and get your codice fiscale on it, okay? Here, cognome means that your surname, guys, you're just write down your surname, and nome means name, so you would put your name here, okay? Data di nascita, asking you the date of birth, okay? So you're putting, for example, I'm putting 14th of August of 2003, as we put it on the Universitaly website, okay? And I'm choosing the male gender here. Here, you could, here, data di nascita, you could write the country you born, okay? For example, you could write, if you're from Pakistan, you write Pakistan. If you're born in the Iran, you just put Iran, okay? Or Israel, or Indonesia, or any other country you got born, okay? So I'm writing down here Iran, as we just choose it in the Universitaly, and we're just clicking on the calculator. It's just going to calculate our codice fiscale and just giving us some sort of codice fiscale here, okay? You're going to just easily copy it here and going to write it down here in the codice fiscale section. And as you may see, I would have my codice fiscale easily obtained and ready here, okay? Documento di identità is your identity document, okay? So for example, if you're, we can say non-Italian, you could have passport. I mean, these two things, I assume they are not used that much useful for the people who are not Italian. You just need to use the passaporto. If you're Italian, so you could have also carte d'identità or patente di guida. So it's easy to choose either of them. But for non-Italians, I recommend to choose the passport here. For example, if you have a passport, if you're putting the passport as a non-Italian person who is going to register, you could write down the document number of your passport, which is written mostly on the most of the passports in the first or second page of their passport in the top or top right corner, as you may see. It has one letter starting with one letter, and it has like 8 different numbers. So you could write down, for example, U or whatever it is, the letters, you could write down your document number, okay? So it is mostly, it contains 8 numbers. So we could write this down here. We could write rilasciato da means it issued by which organ. So for example, most of the people can be consulate or immigration policies. It has several options they could have. Okay, I'm just going to write down as an example immigration police. Why do that? So it is the like we can say it has the several it this in this part in the downside is asking you your document from which date to t which date it is valid. So you just write down the date of date the you just write the start date of your document validity. For example, we can say is 2004 February of 2000 February of 2004. Wait, just 17th February of 2000 2024, sorry. You're going to, for example, most of them they have 5 years of validity. Just we are putting for 17th February of the 2029. Okay, here the residence or domicilio means that which place you are living in. Okay, for example, you could write it depends. If for example you are living in Italy and your domicilio residence are same, you could write down to Italy. Okay, just put the Italy. But if for example it's not, you could write down the country you're living in now. So for example, as we choose Iran, we are now again choosing Iran here, and you just put it the residence, you're putting it EE here, which means that you are from Estero, you are from another from out of Italy. This part is not that much important, so you could just you could write it if you have it. If you don't, you just write it 50. In this residenza is the direction of your the place you're living. For example, you could write down for example we can say Rolmet Street. Okay, so you could write it down here. The password, here the password you could have you could choose a password here, which requires you to have at least 8 characters, which kind of going to have one number and one big letter, capital letter, and one small letter. Okay, and also there are some small special characters. For example, we could write down a password, whatever you just going to choose. Okay. Okay, I just wrote my password here, and here you just need to confirm your password. Okay, and here you're just going to register your document. Now we are going to just research back again to Universitaly website, and now we are going to enter to the website, log into our page. Okay. For example, this is the place that when you, for example, register, you are going to see your name here. Okay, here you could try to find the places that you find your application proceed. Okay, so here, as you can see, there are different places that you could find. For example, for IMA International Medical Admission, that's which is for medical studies, you can find the information here, and this is for the 2023, and there are different information you can find. I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and until the next video, good luck.